change your mind. Take a chance on the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around. If you got no place to go when you're feeling down. If you're all alone.
Done it. You've succeeded. You've engaged in the right series of clicks and types and taps that make the my brother and me advice show for the modern era come out of your speakers or headphones or cans with string. I am, of course, Justin McElroy. I am the oldest McElroy brother.
I'm Travis McElroy, and I am the middlest McElroy brother.
And you can't get more middle than Travis.
I'm Griffin McElroy, and I'm the adopted McElroy brother.
I was going to bring it up this episode if you didn't.
So
you already have.
Real brother, thank you for joining me again.
No problem.
Adopted brother, you didn't have much of a choice, but...
Right. You'd put me back in the cellar.
Back to the cellar with you, dum-dum.
Words hurt.
Words do hurt. Our first question comes to us from Formspring. If you need advice, you can find out how to get it at the end of the program. Dear MBMBaM, have you ever fallen in love with a girl for her taste in music? A girl started making me mix CDs that were surprising and addictingly good, and now I am in love, but maybe just because of the mix. I ask, is there anything wrong with this?
There ain't nothing wrong with a music girlfriend.
Not in the short term, my man.
Yeah, that ain't going to last long, but you can get some sweet burn CDs from them.
Unless...
Most of my collegiate musical taste came from a girlfriend that I had my freshman year of college that burned me like 4 MP3 CDs, not even audio CDs. We're talking like Googles and Googles of music that I still listen to this day.
Googles?
Google
Bits.
It's not going to last long unless the song that unites the two of you is Crazy Game of Poker, because, man, that song never ends.
Once again, this is one of those questions where if you're in high school, yeah, no, that's perfectly fine. If you're 45, it's time to get your ass together, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't think there's anything wrong with judging a person based on their musical taste. I think that says a lot about a person.
I think everybody has that quality. Like, for me, it's TV shows and movies. And I think for other people, it's like video games and music and books and magazines. So there's always going to be that one thing that sparks our interest. Just sure. Build off
for
of that.
For me, it's Pogs.
Well, yeah.
If you find a lady with a fine collection of Pogs and maybe some really heavy alloy slammers.
Just really nice slammers. Like,
look
really...
at the slammers on her.
Wow, look at her slammers. Oh, is that a Digimon on there? Nice. So in closing, it's a fine reason to start a relationship and a terrible reason to continue one.
There it is.
It's great. Another one from Formspring. If you work someplace that lets you interact with many different people, customers, and you're immediately attracted to one of them, is it cool to tell him or her you think they're attractive?
No.
What's up with those slammers, girl? Like those slammers I see across the register?
I'm going to have to go with Travis on this one. No.
No? There's no way to avoid being that dude who's even if you're the nicest guy in the world, there's no way when you're wearing khakis and, you know, your work shirt to not sound creepy.
God. You know, it's okay. Are you going to say you're attractive? Because that's probably creepy. But if you're saying with like body language and stuff.
You just need this Alpo? Do you want me to put it in your bag? You're attractive.
You're attractive.
I like your face.
I'm attracted to you.
I'm attracted to you, man.
I like what you got going on. Seeing you, your body, your face, is setting off chemical reactions inside of my body that finds you very desirable.
My aesthetic sense is inflamed. It's one of those things where, yeah, if you're just paying a compliment, great. It ain't going anywhere. You know,
but you might make them feel better, and maybe you can use that to get ahead in your business, right? Like if you're a real estate agent, like maybe show a little bit of the cleave, and then what's up?
Yeah, what's up?
I'm about that cleave.
Okay, confession time. I once asked a girl out when I was working a waiter job, and I asked her
how'd that work out for you?
Facebook. We went out once, and it was quite terrible.
Sounds bad.
Yeah, so I personally don't recommend it. Also, I felt like the creepiest creepo ever.
You should have.
Yeah, and I did. Like, even as I did it, I was trying to justify it and you can't. I'm surprised the girl showed up and didn't just, like, call Chris Hansen. Because it's creepy time.
Because she was 12 years old.
Yeah, she was 12. Also 12.
You know, this is also, like, so much of our advice. It's highly contextual, dependent upon whether or not you yourself are very physically attractive.
Oh, yeah. No, because if you're banging, forget it.
Yeah, if you're super attractive, super handsome dude, or a super bodacious lady with just real nice slammers, like you are always going to be on the right path by telling people that you find them attractive. It's always acceptable if you're very, very physically attractive. So just
sweet, sweet slammers.
Just the sweetest. Hi, brothers.
Hello.
Hi. I have a problem. I can't start studying for a test until the day before. What should I do to start earlier?
You come to the wrong place, my friend.
No.
How about this? Hey, bitch, just start earlier.
Just do it. Just do the thing. Do the thing you asked how to do. Like,
let's,
you know,
do
the
that
concept. You understand the concept of earlier, so pick a time before the time you normally do it and do it then.
Don't do it now. Do it yesterday.
Now. If you do it now, it's too late. Do it before.
Now, that being said, I do the same thing, or I did the same thing. Because I retained the knowledge better in a short, like in a block before the test, rather than trying to study all week.
Bullshit.
I couldn't hold it in my head that long.
Yeah.
Bullshit.
On the
no,
serious,
I swear
though,
to God.
The only thing I think you can do, which proved to be kind of useful for me, was to get like a I don't want to say study group, because that's not the right vernacular, but like a shared pain group who like will guilt you if you don't study. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the hardest class I had growing up was theater history, and I actually had a study group for that one. And I felt, like, pretty lame about it. As well, I should have. A study group? What is it, 1930? But that worked out well for me. So if you get somebody who will say, like, if you make a study appointment with somebody, like, a few days before, say, hey, we're going to study on Tuesday. Let's just study. Then you will keep that appointment, in theory.
Got to get accountability is what that's called.
Yeah,
got to be accountable.
Got to get that.
Yahoo Answers user Rock just
hey, Rock.
Says, that's spelled R-A-Q, by the way.
Whoa.
I'm figuring that's how he prefers it to be pronounced. Hey, need a film. Not anything like The Lake House or that sort. Desperate for something good to watch. Anything for a 15-year-old girl?
But not,
all right, so
but not
only
in the wheelhouse of The Lake House.
So, the only parameters,
the one criteria
set on this choice,
okay,
might I suggest The Lake House? No, wait, fuck!
Shit!
You choked, McElroy, you choked. Not The Lake House, anything but The Lake House. Hmm.
Oh, God.
What, maybe something that, maybe Walk in the Clouds?
Maybe.
That's
got
that Keanu.
Might be good. I'm trying to think of other Keanu Reeves time travel based rom coms.
Oh, Bill and Ted's Excellent Love Affair.
Bill and Ted's Most Tender Engagement. Traveling through time, kissing George Carlin.
This question is troubling to me because of the addendum. I'm desperate for something different to watch, which makes me think. This is a 15-year-old girl who, her entire life, the only film she's ever watched is The Lake House.
I'm ready for something new.
I would say the Jurassic Park films. That would probably be a good place to start.
Have you tried Titanic? Like, if you've never seen any movies, I don't know where to start with you.
Have you tried anything else?
Because it's not that she hasn't seen any movies. She done seen The Lake House.
Don't even try to quote Lake House to her. She knows all the lines, all the classic lines, like, I've got a time-traveling mailbox, and, whoa.
I live in a house by the lake. That's all
that really is the worst movie ever, though. I feel so bad.
You watched it. Ugh.
Yeah, I watched it.
Oh, that's good.
I'm sorry.
I hate you.
I know. Another one from Formspring. I fall in love with every girl that pays attention to me. Is this normal?
If you're fat.
Sure. Fair.
Right? I mean, right?
I don't know. Like, I get it. I get it. If you're if you've been single for long enough, then that's. I don't think that's such a ridiculous feature.
It was actually something I just learned in the last year. to not view every female that I meet as a potential love interest.
Right. Oh, just now?
Yeah, just like a year ago.
Wow.
Yeah.
Cool.
Sometimes you can just meet and be friends with a girl, and you don't have to, you know, be romantically involved. It's really freeing.
Yeah, nah, you can't do that. But yeah. I see what you're getting at.
Maybe you've never seen a film called When Harry Met Sally.
Or The Lake House.
That's all I've seen.
That might be a good one. Go see When Harry Met Sally. Yeah, that's a good
one.
Did you say Billy Crystals?
I don't think you should. I don't think you should fall in love with every girl that pays attention to you anymore.
No.
That's my advice. Because it's not healthy.
No, it's not healthy. You don't. It's a loser's game. You're a worthwhile person. You have great taste in podcasts. You don't need to fall in love with every girl that pays attention to you.
And also, look at it this way. If you fall in love with every girl that pays attention to you, you will be less desirable to women. Because they don't want that dude. They want someone who is funny and aloof and not desperately trying to get the attention of every woman that pays attention to him. So, you know, play it cool, hotshot.
Play cool.
I've got a bad problem of falling in love with every girl that's pretty on my TV box. Every girl I see on my TV box that I think is pretty, just instant infatuation.
Like Lauren Bacall.
Flo. Wow. Flo from the
Oh, don't get me started about Flo, those progressive commercials. She's my favorite.
She is a cutie. And you know she's got the N for insurance. She can hook you up.
I mean, C.E. Wilson, I guess he's a good enough looking man, but
yeah.
I would hop onto the Flo wagon without
a you would with very little hesitation be a Flo-rida. Wow. From downtown. He sinks it. Gretzky chokes on the open net. My wife and I are expecting first child in a month. She wants some songs that would be good to listen to in the delivery room. Can you give me some great tracks for this special occasion? That's from Thomas via Gmail. No, I think we can come up with something, Thomas.
Oh, manzies. I read this question earlier, and I came up with a really great solution. And I think for the longer portion, the more drawn-out portion, like from when she actually gets posted up in the room,
okay.
And starts squishing out the baby. You put on something soothing, right? Something mellow. Something like Iron and Wine's double-sided LP Around the Well. Just something to bring the mood down to soothe.
Okay.
And then, right when she starts crowning, Thunderstruck by AC/DC.
Wow.
That's great.
So
see, I was going along the
cool
same
jets,
idea. Nazareth, Hair of the Dog. Now you're messing with a sentimental bitch. I think that's the best way for a baby to enter the world.
How did that go again?
I don't want to do that again. I don't want to attempt that again.
I don't think you can do better than Thunderstruck. Like, if you guys want to try and come at me with something else, but Thunderstruck would be the
how
most
about
triumphant.
With Arms Wide Open by Creed?
Fuck you with that.
It's about bringing a baby in the world. It's perfect.
Get out of here. Get out of here with that. Get off the show. Fuck you with that. The obvious answer, by the way, for the special mode of childbirth is Black Hole Sun.
Oh, man.
What kid wouldn't want to make a triumphant entrance to Hurricane 2000? Obviously. Match. Hurricane 2000 is the way to go.
What am I thinking? I was thinking of the orchestral version of Rock You Like a Hurricane.
That is, in fact, Hurricane 2000.
That's what you're talking about?
That's what it is? Okay, because I was going to say
that,
too.
That would be pretty good, I guess.
It would be perfect.
Whatever you
shake
pick,
shake it at
Thomas.
The knees! And then she would really be shaking at the knees, and a baby would come out.
Thomas, whatever you pick, make sure you sing it to her. She'll really appreciate it. And that time, she'll really love it.
Yeah, really loud. Make sure it's with Arms Wide Open, too.
Yeah.
Ugh.
She'll dig it.
Ugh.
Formspring asks, my girlfriend gets a little upset that I don't tend to hug her at night in bed. I explained I just need my own space to get to sleep, but I don't think it made her feel better. How can I keep my own bed space and avoid hurting her feelings?
I think that you should go with the... It depends on how quickly she falls asleep. if she falls asleep early, see, my wife likes to cuddle in bed, but I don't like to touch anything while I'm sleeping. So I'll like
Justin
cuddle
has a hover chamber. Yeah, he just gets in and he just shuts down for the night.
Yeah, I snuggle her until she falls asleep, and then I dog pound it out of that side of the bed. Check out my other side of the bed, and if I'm lucky, I'll have hit a real cool spot on the pillow, got a real cool spot going because I've been relocated for so long.
What I like to do is just straight up cuddle, and then say, hey, I'm going to sleep now, and then roll over. So she gets the cuddles, and then it's your turn, and then it's your time for sleeping.
I've never been married, so I don't know what it's like to sleep in the same bed as a woman.
That's my good boy. Onward, Christian soldiers, onward.
Here's one from Yahoo.
Yahoo?
Yeah, Yahoo Answers user Musso, which may be the Mitchell evil twin brother of Justin Russo.
Yeah, or popular children's singer Mitchell Musso from the hit show Hannah Montana.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
You know they're the same person, right?
Yeah.
What?
Who, Hannah Montana and Miley Cyrus, or Justin Russo and Musso?
Musso Russo?
Okay.
I think it's Justin Russo and Hannah Montana.
Yeah. Well, okay, go ahead.
Which is a better name for a character? Here's another fun little naming game.
Okay.
I'm torn between Jaden and Jacob. Either way, his name is shortened to Jay. My character is 15 years old and is growing up in England. He comes from a middle-class background, yet smokes weed, is a teenage Casanova, and basically a rebel without a cause.
Fuck you! Get out of here!
Which name would suit him better and why? The only reason I didn't go for Jacob, which was my first choice, was because of the werewolf character from the Twilight series. But my book is nothing like Twilight.
Nothing.
Basically, this guy's a rebel without a cause.
More or less.
Basically, more or less. Just don't get in his way, mister, because you don't like Jason Jaden when he's angry. Oh, boy. Golly.
I like any character that's defined as he's from a middle-class background, but he smokes weed every day. As though those two things are mutually exclusive.
Yeah, he's middle class, but, you know, he'll still smoke some weed. What?
Don't even worry about it. He's the narcotic of the proletarians.
What do you want him to smoke in middle class? It's a middle class white guy who will wear some khakis. Whatever. Not a big deal. He's a free thinker. I think your book sounds shitty. I wouldn't I wouldn't read it. I don't see what the concern is with what the character's name is.
But, to answer your question, Jade.
But. Jaden. Mm-hmm. Obviously Jaden. The world has too many Jasons already.
Jacobs.
Jadis?
Jason.
Jadis.
Jada Kiss. Have Jada you considered Kiss. Jada Kiss?
Jada Pickett Smith.
Desiree. Gotta be bad. Gotta be bold. Something like that. Who's that one guy who sang with his shirt off in the black and white video? R&B.
Right Said Fred? What are you talking about?
You know, not Seal.
He had his shirt off in the Desiree video?
No, he's sort of like Desiree.
You gotta give me a song or I can't.
Kind of like Jada Kiss.
You gotta give me a song or I can't.
He's an R&B singer.
Oh, okay. That's a genre.
Decantress, maybe. it'll come to me. I want to say something like Capone is his name. Something
like Capone.
Jada Kiss, Ludacris, something like that.
Ludacris is a thing. He's a guy.
That's
a
person.
Is that what you're going for?
D'Angelo.
That was it.
Got it.
Sweet.
How is that like a pony?
Like Capote.
Like Capote.
Like Capote. Okay. Right. Capote. D'Angelo Capote.
Uh-huh.
Popular district attorney in Boston.
Okay.
D'Angelo Capote.
Can we keep going?
My wife and I. This comes to us from Christian. That's the only way I can think to pronounce that for a man. Christian.
Christian.
Christian from Gmail. My wife and I are going to New York for a week in June. We'd like some advice on what should we do or not do. What was...
Keep going. You can
what
do it.
Must we... I can do it. I keep waiting for it to rhyme, and it's just not... What should we not do? What must we do, see, eat, buy while we are there? Keep in mind, it's our first trip to the U.S., so everything is brand spanking new to us. God! Can't imagine.
I mean, if it's... I think if it's your first trip to the U.S., There are more staple U.S. activities that you need to partake in before, like, New York activities, right? Yeah.
First things first, buy shoes. We got them here.
Lousy with them.
Mm-hmm.
Also, throw some money in the garbage. It's what we do. We don't care.
Get real fat.
Buy a new, like, very consumptive automobile.
Uh-huh.
And then, like, just drive it into a building.
Get one of those Vroom Scoot 2011s. They're really fast, and they'll just burn that oil. If you want a place to go to eat, try Max Brenner Chocolate by the Bald Man. There they have it's not only delicious and New York-y, but they have a chocolate marshmallow pizza that really sums up a lot of American values.
Welcome to America. Really well. Here's your complimentary diabetes.
Yeah, I got this lousy t-shirt and diabetes.
I would say just go to the nearest Walmart or Sam's Club and buy Jimmy Dean's breakfast corn dogs.
Yeah.
And then just eat those the entire time you're within the borders of our nation.
Sorry, no Walmart in New York.
What?
Yeah, that's right.
No Walmart in New York.
In all of it?
In all of the city, there's not a single Walmart. Okay. They would have to leave the city. They would have to take a taxi cab.
Well, maybe you could, like, maybe you could get one, like, under the counter at a Whole Foods.
Probably,
like,
yeah.
They deal in, like, shady, like, so non-Whole Foods there. You got to pay a premium.
Talk to Jerry, the guy that sweeps up. He answers to the name Sweepin' Jerry.
Sweepin' Jerry's got a beat on a breakfast corn dog.
Travis, wait. What show? Should they see a show?
God, I wish I knew any shows on Broadway right now.
What show gets the TSAC seal of approval? What about the Addams Family? That name Elaine's always a delight.
Is Cat still on Broadway?
It is.
Yeah, go
but
see
now
that.
They changed the name to Miss Saigon.
Oh, okay. But still, there's cats in it, right?
Yeah, there's lots of
Siamese cats.
I feel like
cats.
There is something on Broadway right now that I heard about and was like, oh, that sounds so dope, but I can't. Like, it's like a show about, like, a musician or something, but I can't.
Oh, yeah, D'Angelo.
That was it. Wicked. The Addams Family.
D'Angelo.
Promises.
The Addams Family. You're Googling.
Yes,
you
I
make
am.
Me sick.
You know what?
You
actually,
know
go see Blue Man Group. It's awesome.
Oh,
what?
I saw Blue Man Group. That shit's incredible.
What if they're shirtless and it's black and white and they're singing R&B songs? Maybe. And also, it's called D'Angelo the Musical. Max writes to us from Gmail. He says, he's kind of a wordy chap. He says, I've taken a real shine to a girl. Every 20-year-old who writes our program is a 70-year-old man. I just wanted to get that out. I've taken a real shine to a girl. I fancy a young lady. I like the... Never mind. Her bustle is just a delight.
Spring.
Best Lindy Hop in the Tri-County area.
So anyway, I've taken a real shine to a girl I know, and after thinking about whether I have a chance or not, I'm feeling inspired by your advice on the show, have decided to give it a go. Oh, that is your first mistake. After some friendly banter, she asked if I was doing anything later. Yes, and we soon arranged to meet later in the evening.
Okay.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
Tell your
kids
about us.
I wish more people would write and let us know or name them after us, more accurately. Thing is, I'm not 100% certain this is a date.
Oh.
Don't get me wrong. By all accounts, this seems like one when you read it back. Indeed. but this is one of those girls who has a naturally flirtatious demeanor. Ooh. Meaning it could just be a friendly meetup. Here comes the real problem. I prefer to keep this meeting on the down low till I can ascertain the truth of the matter and not have it announced to our social circle that I'm trying to court this girl. Well, Max, I know you're fucking first problem, buddy.
Maybe I... Does your social circle listen to our podcast? Because this is a bad start.
Probably not. Let's be realistic.
Yeah. If not, then you've got an even bigger problem. And that's that you haven't shared this with your loved ones.
I think and maybe this is just me. I don't know how the young people are today. I don't know their various social codes, signals they send to each other. But
LOL. It's all online now. It's all short.
Is it all
online?
See, I was afraid of that. I think that if you make an appointment to do something,
it's a date
with a with a lady and a guy just by themselves, it's a date. Mm-hmm. Like if she invites along other friends or suggests that you invite along other people, it's not a date. But if she's saying, let's just do this, you and me, you gotta assume it's a date. It's on her if it's not a date.
Do not spend the entire date trying to figure out if it's a date or not, or you will fuck it up.
You will fuck it up, bro. You will probably be better off if you act like it's not a date, because that will keep the confidence high. You won't feel like pressure, like, should I hold her hand? Should I kiss her? Should I hold her kiss? Like,
Jada kiss,
D'Angelo, all the questions that seep into a young man's mind. Should I take her to see the lake house again? That's the only movie she's ever seen. What other movies are there?
I take a much a more backwards approach to my social engagements, where at the end of any social engagement I partake in, I try and kiss the other party. And if they take it, then I will know in retrospect that it was a date. And if they fight me off, then I know the truth.
It was really awkward when Griffin got his taxes done.
Well, I don't know, because my H&R Block representative, she was fantastic.
The weirdest was when he was baptized.
And he's had him all over the world.
As far as your friends finding out, don't worry about it. They'll all grow up, and if they're dicks, don't worry about it. It'll be cool.
Exciting. The secret.
Just don't adhere to any labels, man.
Yeah.
Keep that secret.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it doesn't matter if it's a quote-unquote date or not, or if it's just a friendly hangout. If it turns into love.
It's by less pressure if you don't, if it's not a date, because then you can just hang out and see if you, and you know what? Dude, seriously, if you don't hang out with her, treat it like it's a friendship. And if you don't like spending time with her in that context, then you probably don't want to do it again anyway. And honestly, if you like spending time with her, if you don't act like it's a date, you could probably preserve the friendship easier if it doesn't work out.
And actually, that's a great point, because we get asked a lot about, like, friend zone. And I was friend. No one that actually likes you romantically puts you in the friend zone. So there's no concern of, like, I became too good of friends with this person and now they don't want to date me. No, they didn't want to date you before. And they just wanted to be friends with you.
And hey, this goes for him and Max and everybody. Let us know how this stuff works out if you follow our advice. Not that we recommend you do that. But
or anything else we've ever told you to do. Yahoo Questions user Simmons, a.k.a. that guy, asks in all caps, help, my little baby sister drank beer. Hi, one of my little baby sisters who is 11 months old just drank some beer. She didn't drink a lot, and she doesn't seem affected by it, but my mom is freaking out and yelling at all of us, but I think she is fine, and my mom doesn't think so. Can anyone help? And no bullshit, serious answers only.
Take her keys away.
It's
first and foremost.
That baby is in no shape to be driving.
This is another one of those times where we have to remind you of the right time to call poison control and the right time to ask Yahoo Answers what you should do about your situation.
You know,
because it's not now.
Babies think they can party. Babies don't got shit.
These babies come up here. They think that they can roll with the big dogs.
Trying to step.
But they just... I don't think humans get livers until they're like 3.
Yeah.
You gotta earn that shit.
Where's that beer going inside of that baby's gully works?
I think we're missing some important... What beer? Like, what's your first...
That's a big, big
problem. What did you let her have first? Did you let her have some High Life?
If it's like a heady dogfish stout, then that baby's donezo.
That baby's out.
That baby's going to be tripping.
My baby sister just slammed a Rasputin.
What if she had a PBR? You got a hipster baby in your hands now.
Oh, man.
Hope you can find really God's small horn-rim glasses, plaid shirts.
Tiny fixie tricycle.
These jeans don't come any smaller, sir. I'm sorry. You'll have to go to the My Buddy aisle to find smaller jeans for tight, tight hipster babies.
Tight, tight hipster jeans at the Gymboree. But seriously, go to a hospital, I think. Maybe take your sister to a hospital.
Have her drink a glass of water and an ibuprofen and then a glass of water in the morning and she'll be fine.
Yeah.
Also, film that shit and put it on YouTube.
YouTube.
There's my party, baby.
Did you guys hear about Josh?
Mm-hmm.
His problem. He wrote to us Gmail question, our answer. It's coming soon. Just found out my ex cheated on me with her current boyfriend when we were still together. What's the best way to set a person aflame? I think you got to play in one of the hits of D'Angelo and just watch their heart light up, right? Does he mean literal?
Yeah, I was going to say literally fire.
That wasn't
D'Angelo, was it? But
fire and some sort of flammable oils.
They got to be asleep. That's so important.
Or unconscious in some way.
Yeah, you can't just like start. You will never work. You will be shocked at how quickly a motivated man can put out a fire.
Josh, let me drop something on you that Jerry Springer dropped on me when I was 12.
A bottle of beer.
A bottle of beer. That is one of wise Jerry's final thoughts was, if someone will cheat on someone to be with you, then they will cheat on you to be with someone else. So drop that knowledge on her new boyfriend. Like, listen, dude, I don't know what makes you think she wouldn't cheat on you. She cheated on me. Have a great day. Bye. And then dip.
That's possible. Maybe you just didn't love her hard enough.
Yeah.
I know that's kind of a... I know that's a harsh reality, but did you love her as hard as you possibly could?
Hey, you know what? You just said she's your ex.
Yeah.
Who cares, man? Let it go. Move on.
You know what?
Let it go, Josh.
And Griffin, you made a great point, too. No girl cheats on someone or nobody cheats on someone they're happy with. You know what I mean?
Unless they get drunk at their office party.
Unless they get drunk at the office party.
Or the someone is profoundly physically attractive.
Also that. And that's another thing. I'm just going to heads up real quick, listeners. We appreciate questions and we appreciate input and we appreciate you listening. Questions about how to get people with boyfriends and girlfriends to sleep with you? Not really our expertise or something we're going to address.
Not cool.
Yeah.
Not cool. Just be cool. That's the number one advice of MBMBaM.
And
just don't hate.
I'm just going to give you an in general answer to those questions. Question. My friend has a girlfriend I want to sleep with. What do I do? Answer. Realize he's not really your friend.
You guys maybe aren't as close as you thought. Joseph has a conundrum. There's a girl he works with who he met while she was reading about the new Pokemon game that got the conversation started. Now I'm at a loss for what to do next. Should I just go for it and ask her out? I'm really bad at the asking out part. What should I do? What should I ask her out to? Dinner or something else? Maybe
Digimon?
Oh, man. Hold on. Gertrude Griffin, just go ahead.
Yeah. I think maybe you could arrange some sort of series of romantic Pokemon battles, right? Do you know what I'm saying? Maybe kind of sexy Pokemon battles. Like, that could be the way that you ask her out. Like, oh, if my Charizard topples your Venusaur.
How do you feel about a little Squirtle?
And of course you will, because her Venusaur will be weak to your Charizard's fire attacks. That's all I can do. That's all I can summon up. I can't do anymore. I think that...
Ask her about your Pokeballs.
Oh, Jesus.
You could just ask her if you two want to meet up at the next Overeaters Anonymous meeting. I figure you could try that.
Ask her how her collection of cats is doing.
I'm trying to make fun of this guy, but honestly, I feel like his email is pretty much just sort of got it out there.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't want to make fun of him. We just said that it's a good reason to have a relationship with somebody if you both dig Pokemon.
And also, we can poke fun all we want. Dude met a girl.
I don't
want
to make. Dude met a girl. What's up? Beautiful. Keep the human race going.
Yeah.
Just make if beautiful... you had the courage to email a podcast.
Yeah.
To ask them how to ask out a girl who your only contact with her is Pokemon related. I don't think you'll have any problem mustering up the courage to ask her out and do something.
Your balls are huge, dude, is what he's saying. Your Pokeballs.
Your penis are ginormous.
You can see your Pokeballs from space.
And let me give you this advice. It doesn't matter what you do. It doesn't matter what you ask her out to do. As long as you have fun. As long as it is interesting. Be interested in her. The date is not important. The experience is important.
Be interested in her Pokemon, too. That's what she wants to talk about the whole time.
What has she recently evolved?
But you guys are making fun, but, like, dude, if you've got that in, if that's your in, it's unconventional. But you gotta fight. You gotta fight tooth and nail
for love,
for anything you can get.
And you have the best nerd point, like, argument ever. Like, well, I disagree because I met a girl, and you will win every nerd argument like that.
Joseph, if I could just give you one other piece of advice before we move on. Hold on to this one real tight. Just really trust me on this one. Don't let her go, okay? Just, we don't know how many more times this opportunity is going to present itself, by which we mean none. So just really hold on to this one, okay, for me? Just hold
on, buddy.
Tight.
We believe
make
in you.
It work. Trust me. Make it work.
Gordo. That's a great name. Gordo asks on Gmail, I am super whipped by my girlfriend and generally despise my life. My brother and friends say I'm more whipped than even the most whipped guy on TV. I would
What?
No, that's a good metric.
No, haven't you seen the new reality show, The Most Whipped Guy?
I would break up with her, but I feel bad about it, and I'm locked into a few trips that include her. What do I do?
Oh, stop planning trips. Why do you have more than one trip planned?
Step one, start dropping subtle hints asking about refundability of certain trip deposits.
Baby, you know that right. trip we have planned so we in 2015? I returned it. Stop planning trips.
We got Bonnaroo in June, and then the cruise in September, but so help me God...
October rolls around. You guys, listen, man, trust me on this one. Trust me. If you get to a point where you think, I want to break up with somebody, get in a car, find them, and do it right then. Because there's not a second of your life you're not going to spend worrying about it until then. And as soon as you do it, you will feel so much better.
And you are not doing them any favors by waiting.
Yep. Don't go on the trips, because then, like, okay, let's say you got a romantic cabin trip planned for this weekend, right? You're going to go on that cabin trip. Next weekend, you say, I think we should break up. Oh, man, that cabin trip that you just went on is completely invalidated. Yeah. It never happened.
Even
who are you
worse.
Talk about it with your new girlfriend?
Even worse, no. You're going to say nice things on that cabin trip. You're not going to sit on the opposite side. You're going to say, like, baby, I love you. And then the next week, break up with her. That's going to make it messy, dude. And the thing is, a lot of people shy away from breakups because, like, oh, it's going to be messy. Every breakup is messy. It gets better the sooner you do it. It starts healing immediately afterwards. So the longer you put it off, the worse it's going to be.
I know it sucks, man. I know it sucks. You got to do it. Don't waste any more time. You're wasting your life.
And also your money. Stop planning trips.
Stop planning trips. Aaron from Gmail says, how do I comment on my wife's terrible new haircut without lying? Here, let me feed this one for you, Aaron. You ready? Get close. Lie. Glad I could help.
Rob on Gmail says, I'm having a baby girl in June, my first. We have a first name picked out, but haven't chosen a middle. What do you think of the middle name Danger for a girl? My wife says it's white trash, but I don't know any white trash people with the middle name Danger.
Your wife doesn't know shit.
Yeah, sorry, Rob, but those two things shouldn't associate with each other at all.
I generally have a baby naming rule, and that is that naming your baby is not an opportunity for self-expression. Because your kid has to live with it for the rest of their life. That being said, Danger as a middle name is badass. I say do it.
You are raising the sort of person where that's going to shape their life, right?
Absolutely.
They're gonna have to introduce themselves to people. That's going to come up. They're going to associate with people who think it's cool that their middle name is Danger. And that's a cool crowd. That's the kind of people you want.
It'll be great in occasion, like her wedding. Her wedding day, where will be a lot of people in attendance who don't know her middle name. And then the preacher will be like, do you, Eliza Danger McCutcheons, take so-and-so? And everyone in the audience will be like, Danger?
Danger?
Sweet.
Oh, man. Is that real?
Yeah. Danger? I like it. I'm a big fan.
And if she ever becomes like an international super spy, it's right there. Danger right is my middle name. She can actually say, I love it.
Right,
love
but that it. Joke, she's going to hate that joke.
No, unless she becomes an adventurer.
But even then, like, the danger is my middle name thing. Like, people are going to say that to her at parties, and she will get sick of it after, like, the second time.
That might get a little old, actually.
I'm saying that the word itself, the concept of danger as a moniker, is so strong that
yeah. What about adventure?
I like that one.
Excitement.
Punctuality.
Monkey Shines.
Monkey Shines is my middle name. What's the best way to... This is from Maverick 89. What's the best way to remember stuff you've forgotten?
This question is so paradoxical. I've been thinking about it all day, and I can't.
I forgot to think about it. Oh!
What? No, come on.
I
First Creed, now this? A2, Travi?
I'm A2? Sorry. Listen, it's been an off week.
I think you just need to sit a lot down. Of Creed. You gotta sit down in the dark.
Yep.
You just gotta turn on the AC as low as it goes.
Chill. Yeah, low as it goes. Just high as it goes, or just
make the temperature as close to zero as you can get it.
Okay.
Celsius.
Ice down? Ice?
Cover your body in ice and oils.
Okay. Icy oils.
Think as hard as you possibly can about some old shit that happened to you.
Back there, back in the day.
Back in the back of the brain. Because you got shit back there that happened to you, with you. You have memories in there.
Cobwebs.
They are cobwebbed, surrounded. And you got to get back there with the oils and just get them out.
Just dust them out.
So what you got to do is you got to pop some ginkgo.
Dust them off.
Drink a Shasta.
Light some candles.
Get in the dark and just sit and get them out. Watch
just
some
stick
old movies.
Stick that stuff out.
Watch a movie that was created in the year that you were born and just think.
Like the lake perhaps house.
Like Lake House. Were you born in 1997? Like the Lake House?
Think deep. That movie came out in like 2005, dog.
Sorry, dog. My bad. I forgot.
No, but for real, ginkgo it up.
Ginkgo, just
the
ginkgo.
Best way to do it. If you're talking about like something in like recent, like I was gonna say something and I can't remember it, retrace what you were talking about, or just stop thinking about it. The more you're going to think about thinking about it and not actually remember it. As humans, we have a short-term memory and a long-term memory, and getting things to transition about? From short-term to long-term memory is a process.
Didn't you hear the part with the ginkgo and the ice? Didn't you think that pretty well covered it?
I answered this question pretty decisively.
I feel like he's probably already remembered it. He's probably stopped listening already.
Uh-huh.
Maybe he was trying to remember to unsubscribe. Frankly, who can blame him? I know I can't.
Dude, It's Coke asks us via Twitter.
Big news.
After 3 years with my girlfriend, I feel it's time to make the leap and ask for her hand. Any suggestions to make it memorable? All right, guys, let's do it.
First of all, congratulations.
Let's do it. Susan or Marie?
Oh, God, it's our first. Okay.
I know, I'm really nervous.
Okay. Me too. Okay.
Susan or Marie or Ellen or
Tammy?
Let's just say baby. Baby.
Hey, baby.
Hey, sweet baby.
Hey, sweetness.
Dude, It's Coke's been with you for 3 years now.
Three long years, girl.
3 long years, over 1,000 days of pure bliss. Romance.
525,600 times three.
You went on some dates. You had some good times. Met each other. Met each other's parents and friends. You all get along really well. He's been true to you.
He's been there for you.
He's got a really... really important question to ask. Do it, Dude, It's Coke.
Yeah! All right.
Or,
let's do the second one.
It's like a choose your own adventure reaction. Right? She says no.
Dude, It's Coke. That's rough, man.
That's tough. That's tough, buddy.
Hey, listen, there's so many other fish left in the sea.
Yeah, don't even worry about it.
Don't try dating her, because that's not going to work out. It's done.
Nope, it's over.
You had your shot, and you blew it.
You blew it.
But if you did it, and it worked, congratulations.
Yay!
I'm sure she said yes. I'm sure she did, because those kids are so in love.
Unless she didn't. Now, if she didn't...
She didn't.
That is too bad. But, congratulations, or not.
Congratulations. Or fuck you.
Fuck you. Fuck that bitch. She never knew you. She didn't deserve you. Dude, It's Coke. She didn't know you like we do. Fuck her.
Or congratulations.
And we hope we get invited to the wedding.
Thanks for inviting us beforehand. I want to thank you in advance for inviting us to the wedding.
Let's shut this bitch down.
Or fucker. Okay. I want Griffin to tell us his last super important question. But first, I want to remind you of all the different ways you can seek out our wisdom for your very own. You can visit MBMBAM.com. That's a great place to start in case you forget about any of these methods.
Great website. All kinds great of flash website. Games, fun for the kids, social networking.
Yeah.
MP3s, data, JPEGs, and photos.
Smiley faces.
Smiley faces hidden. Can you find it? Easter eggs.
You can hit us up on Twitter. Either do at MBMBAM or we like #MBMBAM. We see a lot of people. I see a lot of people quoting lines from the show with that tag on Twitter. That makes me really happy.
It brings such joy.
Means we're reaching people for once.
Touching.
Reaching out.
We're reaching into them. And we're getting changing inside them. We're changing their minds.
Inside out. There's a FormSpring, of course. There's a link to that on MBMBAM.com. Sorry that Lost wasn't... The finale wasn't as good as you'd hoped or disappointed to. Unless it was awesome.
Which was, yay!
Hooray. And please subscribe and just get a friend. Maybe today, maybe tomorrow. Say... listen, I've got a show, a hit show, hot show that you've just got to listen to with me, and then hold their hand and go on the journey of a lifetime.
And if you are on Facebook, look for the MBMBAM appreciation group. It's really great. Everyone on there is wonderful. We try to release as much news on there as we can. So check that out for late breaking up the minute MBMBAM news.
And email at us also. That's a good one. That's the best one. Is mbmbam@gmail.com.
Yep.
That's a good way to do it.
So, Griffin.
Last question of the day. This one comes from Yahoo Answers user James, who asks, I think I have Pepsi stuck in my lungs. What should I do?
I'm Justin McElroy.
I'm Travis McElroy.
I'm Griffin McElroy.
And this has been my brother and mate.
You will never know me.